Massive trees blocked almost all. Light from the moon. An eerie silence enveloped Cereza. She cautiously ventured onwards.
Cereza, one foot in front of the other. A plant from Inferno. I wonder how it will respond to my magic.
Yeah.
Looking into the dark underbrush, Cereza could not shake the feeling that someone was looking back. As the wind rustled the leaves, it sounded just like a rasping voice whispered in her ear.
I can't turn back now. I'm going to become a witch and save Mummy. What was that? Must have been a rabbit or something. Right, Cheshire? Is someone out there?
Cereza could not shake the feeling she was being watched.
Is someone there? Show yourself!
And then, as if to answer her call, these were fairies, nefarious creatures who ensnare the souls of humans who venture into the woods to feed on their vitality. This time there was nowhere to run. Cereza was backed into a corner.
Please, please walk this time.
Fingers crossed, Cereza prepared to use the summoning spell she learnt from Morgana. Even after the summoning circle had faded away, no one had answered her call.
Why? I did everything right!
The fairies resumed their sinister mission. All at once, they jumped at Cereza, weapons poised to strike. She shut her eyes tight and prepared for the worst. A moment passed, and then another, but she felt not so much as a pinprick.
What? Who are you?
Chomp!
Ah!
That beast, as dark as a moonless night, had it all been a dream?
You don't think... Could that have been...
But before Cereza could finish her question...
Cheshire?
From its gaping maw, extending ear to ear, fell a drop of thick slobber.
Wait, did I manage to summon a demon that has now possessed Cheshire?
As if in reply, the beast growled and bared its blood-red fangs. Just as Cereza feared, a demon had indeed possessed her beloved stuffed cat. The creature had desperately sought a medium in order to survive in our world. In lieu of hair, it settled for one made of felt. Looking around, the demon's eyes found Cereza. It let out a low growl. After her initial terror, Cereza realized that she was able to understand what the demon was saying.
You want me to return you to Inferno? Now, how would one go about doing that?
Cereza had her hands full calling a demon to this world. She hadn't even begun to study the spell to send them back. Cereza once again heard the demon's words, this time even more clearly. Send me back! Send me back! The demon's rage increased by the second, but there was nothing Cereza could do. Out of patience, he pounced. Claws like daggers descended on Cereza. But what if we hear? The demon had stopped cold. As if bound by an invisible force, no matter how he struggled, he was unable to touch Cereza.
Calm down! You're going to burst a seam! Don't worry, I'll send you home. Once I figure out how... I'm on my way to get a fantastic power. With that, sending you back should be a piece of cake.
Giving up his attack, the demon turned his attention elsewhere. Intrigued but a little scared, Cereza decided to follow a bit behind. The demon ran through the forest, searching for a way home. Fairies. The demon slashed with his razor-sharp claws. But something felt off. His power seemed to escape him, slowly but surely.
What's wrong?
The demon bared his fangs. He was clearly suffering.
Are you sick? Or hungry, perhaps?
As Cereza approached, the demon felt the strength return to his body. In an instant, he felt right as rain. His body was linked to Cereza by powerful magic. Moving away from her robbed it of its energy.
What's that? I need to stay close to you? I've never heard of a spell like this before.
How do you plan on getting me back to Inferno?
The demon demanded.
We first need to find a white wolf. He'll show us the way.
Leave it to me. I'll find him,
said the demon as he clambered to his feet.
I'm Cereza. What's your name?
I have no name,
replied the demon curtly.
You don't have a name? That must be terribly inconvenient. Though I must admit, I haven't the faintest idea about demonic manners. May I call you Cheshire? That's the name of the stuffed cat you decided to borrow after all. Well, I need to call you something. If you're going to make a fuss about it, why don't you just find a new body? Fine! I'll just call you whatever I please!
And so these strange companions set off in search of the White Wolf. What mysteries await in Avalon Forest? The demon seemed to have calmed down. Remembering that he could not touch her, Cereza breathed a sigh of relief. Pungent scent tickled Cereza's nose. It was rosemary, often used to ward off evil spirits. As soon as the scent reached Cheshire, he pulled away, face scrunched up in disgust. It looked like demons could not stand being anywhere near the flower. This was quite a pickle, but Cereza knew how to get by without a scratch.
Cheshire, I've got it tied down! Finish it!
At once, Cheshire's body shrunk to its original cuddly form.
Cheshire!
Cereza ran to pick up Cheshire and held him tightly to her chest. In her arms, Cheshire felt his strength returning.
Release me at once!
Even in this form, the demon did not seem happy about being cuddled.
Just hold still, will you? While you're small, you can't walk on your own, right? I'll carry you until you can transform again. Not having a massive demon breathing down my neck will make it easier for me to calm down too.
While far from pleased about being treated like a stuffed animal, the demon had no choice but to swallow his pride.
Thank you. Mary. Cheshire, I'll toss you up there. See if there's a way forward. Make this. I wonder what's inside. Cool! run.
There were signs that a witch had set up camp here.
Perhaps I'm not the first witch to enter this forest. Oh well, it means we've got a place to rest. Look what we have here! Take a break.
Thank you.
Before them stood a large wolf. Its snow-white fur shone, pale silver in the moonlight.
Avalon Forest, the white wolf guide you.
Cereza was captivated by the wolf. It seemed almost not of this world. The world before Cereza seemed to warp and bend. She blinked hard, to no avail. Could this be a fairy trick? Cheshire was losing patience with his hesitant companion.
Come on! We've still got that wolf to catch!
I'm getting ready. Just give me a second.
As soon as she took a step inside, she felt as if the breath had frozen in her chest. All around her were sights strange and terrible, as if she had been dragged into a waking nightmare.
I'm fine. It takes more than this to scare me. Supposed to find my way in here.
Suddenly, Cereza's magic brace began to glow. What could it be? Revealed things Cereza was unable to see before.
Does this brace have the power to dispel illusions?
Upon close inspection, there appeared to be distortions, as if the air itself had cracked. Equally confused, the girl and demon exchanged a glance.
That wolf is just up ahead.
Cheshire's indecision did not last long, but try as he might, he was unable to open the cracks any further.
Try using magic to open it? Come on! We have no idea what's lurking on the other side.
Cheshire gave a mocking snort at Cereza's cowardice.
I am not making excuses! All right, fine! Okay, Cereza. Just like you practiced.
Once their eyes had adjusted to the brilliant light, what lay before them was a sight unlike anything either had seen before.
Cheshire, I have a feeling we're not in Avalon anymore.
Thank you.
Cheshire, over here! Treasure? They'd be hopping mad if I stole it. Yes! Yes! You're the boy from my dream.
Center of forest. Waiting. Help me. How?
Okay. I just need to follow the white wolf, right?
Destroy all elemental crows. You can do it. Follow White Wolf.